Children, turn on the videos. Gauri, how many members were there in the Constituent Assembly for India?
389.
Question, for India.
99.
This is the problem. If a question is there, you will write 389 and you will say, ma'am, I wrote every answers. Devasena, Ashik, Alna Rose, Elsa, all of you turn on your videos. So how many members are there? 299. It's not 399, okay. 389 members were there when the Constituent Assembly was formed. But after that, what happened?
Partition of India.
So Constituent Assembly was also split to two, the Constituent Assembly of India and the Constituent Assembly of Pakistan. So I think till the that topic we discussed in the last class, right?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am. Yes.
Then another question will be there. Why should we accept the constitution made by the Constituent Assembly more than 70 years? See the question. A question is there. Why we are accepting the constitution made by the Constituent Assembly more than 70 years? See, this Constituent Assembly was formed in which year?
1949.
Which year?
1949.
Constituent Assembly was formed in, or the draft, the cabinet mission plan was in? Okay, Arun. We discussed about the cabinet mission plan in the last class. In which year?
1946.
So the cabinet mission plan gave the approval for the Constituent Assembly. That means it started its work in 1946. And it enacted the constitution in 1949. And it came into force in 1950. Okay? So India adopted the constitution. It came into force in 1950. From 1950 to 2020, we can take the current year 2020. We are following the same constitution. Right?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes. Why?
Yes, ma'am.
So the next topic is, why should we accept the constitution made by the Constituent Assembly more than 70 years? Why? Why, any idea? Okay, see. Many countries of the world rewrite their constitutions, or they rewrite the basic rules which were not accepted by all major groups or the political parties in the country. So the majority of the countries in the world, they rewrite their constitution. The many countries of the world rewrite their constitution because that is not acceptable to the major social groups or the political parties. Almost all the countries, their constitution may be written before 50 or 60 or 70 years back. So nowadays, it is not much relevant to the present society. So many of the countries, they rewrite their constitution. Why? Because it is not acceptable for the political parties or the social groups in the countries. Or in some countries, the constitution is considered only as a mere paper. That is, they are not giving any value for the constitution. But the experience of the Indian constitution is extremely different. In India, nobody challenged the legitimacy of our constitution. No political parties or no social groups challenged the legitimacy of our constitution. our constitution is acceptable for all. That's why we are following the same constitution even after the 70 years. Why we are following the same constitution? Because there is no social group or political party, however, questioned the legitimacy of the constitution. No one questioned the legitimacy or the validity of the Indian constitution. Okay? So why it is acceptable? The first reason is no one questioned the legitimacy or the validity of the Indian constitution. That's the first reason we are accepting the constitution after the 70 years. Then, the another important reason, when we discussed about the Constituent Assembly itself, it include around 299 members from different parts of the country, right? It not only include the members from a particular part of the country, it include the members from different parts of the country. From Jammu Kashmir to Kanyakumari, we have representation. That means from all the states of India, we have representatives to, from almost all the states of India, we have representatives to the Constituent Assembly. So the Constituent Assembly represent the people of India. First reason is no one challenged the legitimacy of Indian constitution. Then it was elected mainly by the members of the existing provincial legislature. These members are elected from the different provinces. Provincial legislature, that means from different areas, they selected the members to the parliament. Sorry, to the Constituent Assembly. Then this helped to ensure a fair geographical share of the members from all the regions of the country. That is the meaning of this. And the Constituent Assembly represents the people of India. Why? Because it includes the people from different geographical areas. The people from different geographical areas are there as a members of the Constituent Assembly. And also it represents the different language groups, caste, religion, and occupation. That means it shows. Now you, and I hope you, it is easy for you to understand the meaning of the first sentence. The Constituent Assembly represented the people of India. That means it includes the people from different geographical areas. It includes the people from different caste, class, religion, and also from different occupation. That means the Constituent Assembly include the members which they can reflect the needs of the country. It is not only really concentrated to a particular area. It includes the members from different parts of the country. The people belonging to different caste are there. The people belonging to different religion were there. The people who are doing different occupation are there. So the Constituent Assembly, even now we are accepting the constitution. Why? Because it represented the people of India. Clear, children? Is it clear?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes or no?
Yes,
Lakshmi, is it clear? Okay. So why? The first reason is nobody challenged the legitimacy of Indian constitution. There is no social group or no political party, however, questioned the legitimacy of the constitution of India. Second one is it represents the people of India. Why it represents the people of India? Because it includes the members from different geographical area and also the people who are belonging to different caste, religion, and also from the people who are doing different occupations are there, the members of this Constituent Assembly. So it helped to reflect the views of all the categories of people when drafting the constitution. Clear? It represents the people of India. The term, what does it mean by it represents the people of India? That means the people from different geographical area, caste, religion, and occupation are there, are the members of the Constituent Assembly. Clear? The Constituent Assembly, the third reason is that it worked in a systematic manner. The Constituent Assembly worked in a systematic and open manner. First, some basic principles were decided and agreed upon. So the Constituent Assembly also, it took 3 years for its completion, but it worked in a systematic manner. And first, it decided some of the basic principles which they want to be agreed. And then the drafting committee, who chaired the drafting committee? Who is the chairman? Who was the chairman of drafting committee?
Dr. B. R. Ambedkar.
Dr. B. R. Ambedkar. Don't forget his name. Dr. B. R. Ambedkar. He prepared a draft constitution for discussion. See, he prepared a draft constitution for discussion. So the Constituent Assembly worked in a systematic manner. They came up with some basic principles they want to agree. And then the drafting committee chaired by Dr. B. R. Ambedkar, they prepared the constitution and they draft the constitution for an open discussion. Lakshmi, is that your brother? Then several rounds of thorough discussions take place on the draft constitution by each clause by clause. So after they drafted the constitution, they presented it for a discussion. Then from each clause of the or each laws of the constitution, they discussed. They gone through a thorough discussions about the clause by clause discussion where they are related to the constitution. So the several rounds of thorough discussions were going on. Or the thorough discussions took place on the draft constitution by clause. So the Constituent Assembly worked in a systematic and an open manner. Then first they came up, agree with some of the basic principles. Then the Constituent Assembly headed by Dr. B. R. Ambedkar, chaired by Dr. B. R. Ambedkar, they put forward the constitution for an open discussion. Then each and every clause of the or each and every laws that is written in the constitution were discussed. And more than 2000 amendments were considered. I think it's a new term for you, amendment, right? Amendment means if we are changing something in the constitution, we use the term amendment. If we are making any changes in the constitution, we are using the term amendment. Don't use the term change. We must use the term amendment. So constitutional amendments are there. If we are changing any clause or any article or any part or any law in the constitution, we are using the term amendment. That we will study, okay? So the more than 2000 amendments, more than 2000 laws or the articles or the parts, the constitution, see children, the constitution is include articles, okay, and parts and schedules. It is divided into 22 parts and 12 schedules and 409 articles something. I will check it and I will say it once again, okay? So it is divided into different parts, different schedules and different articles. So if anything they want, they changed, more than 2000 changes they made in the Indian constitution. More than 2000 changes they made in the constitution they drafted. And every documents presented and every word spoken in the Constituent Assembly has been recorded and preserved. And these are called the Constituent Assembly debates. So more than 2000 amendments were there, or more than 2000 changes were they made in the constitution they drafted, and they recorded, they marked each and everything they discussed in the Constituent Assembly. And these records are called as the Constituent Assembly debates. What do you mean by the Constituent Assembly debates? All the recorded and the preserved documents related to the constitu documents presented by the constitution or the documents presented and every word spoken in the constituent assembly has been recorded. The recorded and the preserved part of the constitution. Whatever things they discussed, all the things they recorded and they preserved. That is called as the constituent assembly debates. Okay, all the things they discussed in the constituent assembly were recorded and preserved. It's called as the constituent assembly debates. And when they printed that, it include 12 bulky volumes. These debates provide a rationale behind every provision of the constitution, and these are used to interpret the meaning of constitution. That means more than 2000 changes they made it in the drafted constitution, and what all things they did, they made it as a record, and it is called as the constituent assembly debates. And these include 12 bulky volumes. That means what all things they discussed there, all the things are a record now. So once again, why should we are accepting a constitution made by the constituent assembly more than 70 years? Why we are accepting the constitution made before 70 years? Even now we are following a constitution which is made beyond 70 years. Why? The first reason is nobody challenged the legitimacy of Indian constitution. Why no one is challenged? But in many countries, they rewrite the constitution or they consider it as a mere paper. But in India, nobody challenged the validity of the Indian constitution. Then the constituent assembly represented the people of India because it includes the members from different geographical areas, different caste, religion, occupation, and all. So it helped to express their own views when they are drafting the constitution. The third one is the constituent assembly. It worked in a systematic and open manner. It worked in a systematic and open manner. First, it came up with some principles. Then it agreed, and they. Constituent assembly chaired by Dr. B.R. Ambedkar drafted the constitution for prepared a draft constitution. They prepared a draft constitution for discussion. So the discussions were going on based on each clause by clause of the constitution, and around 2000 amendments were made in the constitution. And they recorded each and everything they discussed in the constituent assembly were recorded, and these records are called as the constituent assembly debates. It's a new term to you, the constituent assembly debates. That means the each and every word spoken in the constituent assembly were preserved and recorded. These recorded documents are called as the constituent assembly debates, and when it is printed, it included 12 bulky volumes. That means they went thoroughly through each and every clauses of the Indian constitution. Before we are adopting the constitution, or at the time of they are drafting the constitution itself, or after completing the drafting, and all each every process they discussed it in detail and they evaluated in clause by clause. That's why they made more than how many amendments? How many
2000.
Amendments? 2000 amendments in the constitution. Clear?
Yes.
Yes. To everyone.
Yes,
any
ma'am.
Doubt? Any doubt? When I am asking the question, don't say I didn't understood. Any doubt?
Ma'am, can you show the last slide?
Sorry,
can we show the last slide?
Slide, yes. this one, right?
Ma'am.
Yes.
Ma'am, can you explain the last point?
This point. When printed, these debates are 12 bulky volumes. That means this Constituent Assembly debates, they printed it. After all the discussions, all the things, what all things they are discussed there, they recorded it and finally they printed it. That is used. These are used to interpret the meaning of the Constitution. Even now, these bulky volumes are there and these are taken to interpret the Constitution. Okay, Lakshmi?
Yes, ma'am.
Which one, dear? Okay, the last point. Last point means the Constituent Assembly worked in a systematic and open manner. The Constituent Assembly worked in a systematic and an open manner. So first what they did is, first they drafted the Constitution, or first they made the Constitution. And it is there for an open discussion. Each and every clause, that means what all things they written in the Constitution, each and every line they went through that. And if any changes, amendment means the changes. If any changes needed, they made some changes in that. Okay. After that, these changes, all the things, what all things they discussed in the Constitution, Constituent Assembly is recorded. These records are called as the Constituent Assembly debates. And it is published as a, when it is printed, it becomes a 12 bulky volumes. In the case of Dr. B.R. Ambedkar means he drafted the, after drafting the Constitution, they, it is there for an open discussion. That means each and everything, what all things they written in the Constitution, clause by clause, session by session, they studied it in detail and open discussions were there. And if it is, they made, if any changes needed, they made some changes at the time when it is drafting itself. Clear? Drafting the Constitution means at the time when they are making the Constitution. Clear to everyone?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, Justin. Justin,
yes, ma'am.
Can you say the any one point, dear? Why we are accepting the same Constitution? Any one point? Why, Justin?
Ma'am?
Yes.
In some other countries, the constitution exists as more piece of...
You, in your own sentence, you can say. No need for saying what you have seen in the slide. Okay, just say what. In many of the countries, the constitution is considered only as a paper. Then what about India?
No one can challenge the validity of...
Yes. Nobody challenged the legitimacy of the Indian Constitution, right? Justin?
Yes,
nobody challenged the validity of the Indian Constitution. Then... Who will say? Srihari, can you say another point? Things we heard. First one is about the legitimacy we discussed. Second, we discussed about what?
There are more than 2,000 amendments.
There are more than 2,000 amendments, okay. That means the Constituent Assembly worked in a?
systematic and open manner.
The point is the Constituent Assembly worked in a systematic and open manner. Why it is worked? Why you are saying that it is worked in a systematic and open manner?
I mean the drafting time. The laws were allowed to be discussed openly. Yes,
after drafting the constitution, they analyzed the constitution by clause, right? Then,
there were more than 12 bulky books, records.
No, suppose then there is a more than 2000 amendments where or changes were made in the constitution. Then each and everything they
recorded.
Recorded. Each and everything were recorded, and this when it is printed, it become 12 bulky volumes. Okay, all the things. Why is it necessary to byheart it? Now you understood the concept, right? Then why you are byhearting it? Read the textbook again, okay? And if you are not getting, you inform me. Then Sania, one more point is left. Sania, can you say? Sania, loss of connectivity. Yes, one more point is there.
The Constituent Assembly process.
Yes, very good. The Constituent Assembly represents the people of India. The people from all over the country were there in the Constituent Assembly. So children, read the textbook. The next class, definitely I will ask to everyone this question. Only then I will go to the next topic. Okay? So study well for the next class. Thank you all.
Thank you, ma'am.
Bye. Bye.